We're okay.
We're okay.
We're gonna make it. I love you.
I love you.
Oh,
what makes a man? I always thought about the smaller things, the tangible things, like fast cars, high income, babes falling at my feet. I wanted the possessions of life, but I never cared about the passions of life. But one day, it all changed. My name is David Horsenfeld, and this is the story of how I fell in love with a cave woman.
You are a winner. You own your own universe.
I am a winner. I own my own universe.
You are special. Special people win.
I am special. Special people win.
You are the master of your own...
I'm the master of what? What am I the master of?
Hey, what are you doing?
Hey, take a chill pill, Pelican. I'm a winner.
Look it up, lady.
too. Check it out. It's First Communion. It's nice.
Thanks. Thanks. You like it? I ironed it myself. It's, you think it's okay?
Oh, yeah.
Sorry, I can't hear you. Your tie's too loud. Look, not today, okay? Today I'm ready for change. I mean, if you saw me walking down the street, would you say this guy is ready for change?
Sex change?
No, like a change of job. Today I'm asking for a promotion.
Well, I hope you're perfectly aware that you can't have my job.
Well, I don't want your job.
Well, you can't have it.
Well, I don't want it.
Well, you can't have
it.
Well,
I don't want it.
Well, you can't have it.
I don't want it.
You smell funny.
I'm wearing the same cologne that Marvin wears. I'm gonna show him we're of like mind.
Yeah, well, he wears it, Dave. He doesn't bathe in it. Ooh, crucial meeting. Gotta go. It's just me and him. Bye-bye.
We here at BMC understand how compelling it is to tease, to seduce. Give the morose masses a thrill. Give them a fantasy they can hold on to when their significant other turns away from them in the marital bed. Give them another person that they can be. One that they will pay us to be. They give us the remuneration, and we give them the illusion. Roger? Tasty little morsel, isn't it?
I hate it. Loathe. 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 It's a travesty. A disaster. My doggy could have done better, Marvin.
So then would that mean you didn't like it?
Oh, someone get me a latte quick before I have a stroke. I'm starting to leave my body. Oh, hello. Hello. I hate it when I leave my body.
Jean-Michel.
Don't you take another step towards me, you.
Yo, my knees may advise you to guard your grill and step off.
Yeah.
What did he say? What did he just say?
Well, sir, basically he said back off.
On the strength.
Word. Jean-Michel, let's just massage this a little, huh?
No. I hate it. Can't you see it? She looks like a boy. She doesn't have hips. She doesn't have cleavage. Get real, Marvin. Androgyny is dead. I'm not interested in transcending gender. I made a perfume for women called Primal. Get me a woman. I want an animal to represent my perfume. Fiona, find me. Now. Now. Now!
Jean-Michel, you're right. The actress in this commercial is nowhere near the outstanding quality that you need for your spokesperson. I told you that the actress in this commercial had nowhere near the outstanding quality that Jean-Michel would need for his commercial. You! Find me an animal!
An animal.
Mr. Beckner, sir.
What?
Shelley,
gather up all you little nerds. Let's get some new graphics for the Primal account. Hi there, Stephen. Dump those black and white commercials that you thought were so great. And find me an animal for tomorrow's Primal shoot. I want a woman who is an animal.
Don't look at me like that. I have married two of them myself. I have their heads mounted on my living room wall. They can't be that hard to find.
Mr. Beckner?
Out of my way.
Mr. Beckner, what is it? Can't you see that I am...
My name is...
Who are you?
I'm David Forsenfeld, sir. I've been working in traffic for 5 years. Have you gotten any of my emails? Well, I've come up with new concepts for our clients. You see, I've been focusing on my long term. I'm zeroing in on my assets. I've hit the glass ceiling, and sir, I think I'm ready to be utilized as an advertising executive. I own my own universe, and I'm a winner.
What do you want?
I want a promotion.
What did you say?
I want a promotion.
A little romance. I'm not just an object, you know. walk, Nellie. She must have been power walking to tone her inner thigh muscles.
I told you, she just showed up. She must be homeless.
What is that on your face?
Oh, I found this new product. It's mashed infant poo and aloe. It's pure. It removes unwanted facial hair and wrinkles.
You don't have wrinkles.
But I will. And I have these arm restraints. They tone your upper arms. And I know I'm going to take off 5 pounds of water tonight in my body wrap.
Why do you do this to yourself?
I'm improving myself. So what are you going to do about her? Are you going to call the cops?
What am I going to tell them? Some insane woman came in my house, scarfed all my food, and had her way with me? That'd be a normal Saturday night for most guys.
I've got to go chant for what I want and go to sleep. I will be thinner. I will be taller. I will find the perfect lipstick. I will find perfect lipstick. I will find the perfect lipstick. I will find perfect lipstick.
Who are you, anyway? My parents never warned me that things like this could happen. They just said I'd catch a cold if I forgot my sweater. How was I supposed to handle this? I was a delicate guy. She wouldn't stop staring at me. But I hid my fear. I looked calm. I didn't want her to jump me again. Maybe this time she'd win.
You'll have to agree that tonight's story of boy meets girl is a little unusual. It's not every day you meet a million-year-old cave woman. Hello, I'm Michael Eisner, head of the Walt Disney Company. The idea of finding prehistoric beings is not that far-fetched. I mean, not long ago in Europe, the frozen remains of a prehistoric man were found in the Alps, buried in a glacier. Unfortunately, he didn't come to life. I understand that prehistoric women have yet to be found. That is, until tonight's amazing discovery. Speaking of prehistoric women, a little problem has come up that I have to deal with. Enjoy the rest of tonight's feature. So, how long has your girlfriend been missing?
Disney Films Presents will continue in a moment here on ABC.
She wasn't there, and I was glad because I was determined to get my job back and reclaim my life.
Oh, come on, people. We're losing daylight.
We're inside, stupid.
Yes, well, we're losing light bulbs then, because they're all going to burn out before she ever makes some magical appearance. Oh, I know you can hear me, Ivana. Darling. Can you hear me? Ivana! Ivana!
Oh, Ryan, I'm here.
Ah, well, here she is, everyone. Look, and the cows haven't even come home yet.
They were working on my lips. Hello, lips? I just had collagen and it hurts, okay?
Oh, okay. Except this little problem, you see, we're 2 hours late because while you were out partying all night, we were all quite comfortably tucked away in bed, dreaming this fantastic dream about you actually showing up for work on time. This is a profession, Ivana. We're all professionals here.
Oh, I'm sorry. I thought that I got paid $20,000 an hour because I'm an amateur!
Well, you certainly must love humiliating me, darling. So, we'll just pretend it never happened and we'll get right back to work.
All right, darling, give me that animal now. That's it. Oh, show it to me. You prey on the innocent. You seduce men mean nothing to you.
Which little bunny man. Oh, look, there goes one now. You're going to eat his brain.
Yes, come on. Come on. You're a wild animal. You're running free on the tundra. You're running wild. You're chasing tourists. You're clawing, and it's like a wild animal park. You're on the hood. You're looking in. You're fascinated by the windshield wipers. You don't know what they mean.
Yes, that's it. Well, that's sort of it. Come on, darling. You are woman fountain. Fountain of life. Come on, darling. Give it. Ivana, I want a wild animal, not some domestic chihuahua, darling.
Okay. Now, give me that animal, baby. You're wild. You're in the tundra. You seduce.
Men on the run. You are Gaia. You are power woman. Come on, darling. Give me something here, will you? Whoa.
20 years has died. I'm feeling vulnerable. And I've just sprinkled her ashes over my private island.
Go on.
I am giving you the claw. I am giving you the eyes. I'm giving you the... I don't know what you want me to do. I'm trying to be an animal.
Well, darling, all you're really giving me right now is a mineral, perhaps a vegetable at best. Show me that animal need. You don't appear to be in need of anything.
I'll tell you one thing I don't need. I don't need room temperature water. Underneath these lights, I'll bloat. Why does he keep yelling at me?
Excuse me, Mr. Beckwith, to remember me, you inadvertently dismissed me yesterday, and I was wondering if maybe we could just take a few baby steps backward and reassess the situation.
Get out of my face and change that suit. You're a mess.
It's the only one I have.
Well, it's an ugly one. Say bye-bye now. What is that? Ah! Oh! You know that?
It's my, cousin.
Ah! Oh, God, what is she doing?
She's smelling our cologne. You and I wear the same cologne because we're of like mind.
Get out of here. Get out of here. You and your squalid cousin, and you're fired again. You nauseate me, and she needs a bath.
I'm so exhausted.
What does everyone a debutante? Ivana, just do the shoot. The next time you walk down a runway, it'll be in overalls to flag in aeroplanes.
I have an idea, everyone. Why don't we play some music? Would that do the trick, darling?
Side of the female odyssey.
Yes, yes.
yum, 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 yum.
I am having a happy. I am having a very large happy right now. This girl is it. She is so sublime, so very, very. She embodies it all. Passion, turbulence, vitality, strength, substance, and unruly edge.
Hello? I'm ready to work now. Are we shooting or what?
Ivana, love you, babe, but you're a wrap. People! I have an announcement to make. I have finally found the spokesperson for my primal. She will introduce it at my fall Diplé de Mode.
Enjoy your 1 second of fame, Lucy. You're not from around here, are you? I mean, I know all the girls. We're a very tight family. Parlez-vous français? Well, I just wanted to let you know that whatever immigrant boat they fished you off of, it won't last. You see, faces like yours, they come and go, but mine will always be here. I'll make sure of it.
Shelter or grew up with wolves in the valley. I don't know where she came from. Look at her. She's my ticket to success. Everyone loves her. Jean-Michel loves her. Marvin loves her.
Well, at least make her bay, David. It's not civilized.
Thank you.
any description of anyone, she's got long, matted hair, and she smells, and she doesn't speak. Hello?
Dr. Lankford, could you come in here for a second?
Is there a problem with the DNA model?
No, it's lovely. Dr. Lankford, do you remember the earthquake?
Oh, yes, a 6.3. It was a doozy. Caltech is
Do you remember what they said they found in the newspapers? You know, something about something in the glaciers in the Hollywood Hills.
Oh, yes. Priceless artifacts, millions of years old. Almost as intriguing as when they found the first walking tribe in Africa a few months ago, the Gaia and Encino. Mm-hmm. But these artifacts are from the Mousterian era. Balls, arrowheads, spears.
Spears? Dr. Lambert, this is a far-out question, but do you think it's possible that a person could be frozen and then come back to life again?
Cryogenically preserved in the glacier?
Uh-huh.
I'd have to say that's impossible.
Huh. Maybe it's not so possible.
What do you mean she's a cave woman? Are you completely insane?
I got this out of the newspaper. Read it.
Perfectly preserved Mousterian bowls, tools, and artifacts were found at the dig site in the Hollywood Hills. So what?
No, keep reading.
Also found at the site were spears and a glacial coffin that may have contained a human being. Hair has been recovered from the site and is currently being carbon tested. Okay. You know what? I don't want to know this. I refuse to believe this.
See, she must have gotten caught in an avalanche before the ice melted. That way, her vital organs would have shut down, and then when she came out of the ice, they would have started back up again.
This person in my fireplace is prehistoric?
It all makes sense. The way she was dressed, the way she looked, the spear. And check this out. Cave drawing she did at school today. The fact that she doesn't speak, how no one reported her missing. You know, it's like that guy they found in Encino a couple of years ago, or that Bronze Age guy from the Alps.
Okay, cool. I can work this. I envisioned ruthless exploitation, celebrity endorsements. This could make me rich. I'd be a player. Girls would love me. I wondered where I could find a good tailor.
No.
Bad, Steve Girl, bad.
I mean, this is a modern living. To get used to it.
Don't talk back.
Hello?
Oh, yes, sir.
Pronto. Woo!
No, don't run that one. That's not English.
not since Grandpa dropped out of the board meeting and we had a family member in this room.
So you are his cousin?
Yes.
Why don't you step outside, Henry?
David.
Yeah. Why don't you and Roger just take it on outside? I'd like to speak to your cousin alone. Now, gentlemen.
Yes, sir.
You know, Lucy, I can't impress upon you enough the profound impact that you had on Jean Michel himself and the entire count.
Yes.
Tell me something. Did you invent this situation so that you could gain Jean Michel's attentions, huh?
Yes.
I knew it. Clever. Lucy, I can tell by your accent that you're foreign. Where are you from? I couldn't quite hear that. Oh, I'm sorry. I had Thai food last night. Oh, where are you from?
Hungary.
Oh, you're from Hungary. Really? You know, Lucy, you're very, very charming.
Do you mind if I join you?
Do I just lick up? This cousin of yours is from Hungary.
Hungary? Oh, Hungary, yes, he certainly is, Mark.
Dennis?
David.
Don't you ever, ever, even after you're long dead, ever call me Marv.
Yes, sir.
Tomorrow, your cousin has an 11:30 call for Jean Michel. Try and teach her some English by then. I don't want Jean Michel to think that we're saddling him with some uncivilized idiot.
She's not an idiot.
America! America! God shed its grace on thee and crowned thy good with brotherhood from sea to shining sea. Now you're the ones and the only ones who because you are real Americans. You cared enough to come all the way here to be free. Yes, and kudos to you. Because you cared enough to want to learn the mother tongue. Revolution. Say it after me. Repeat it. Revolution. Gender for everybody. Gender. Let me hear you say it.
Revolution.
Be free!
Yes.
Get down! Return your culture!
Love yourself. Let me hear you say it.
Love yourself.
Love yourself!
Grace. On you.
Why don't you tell my partner?
No.
No. Look, you're not the only one with teeth. Look. Okay. Okay, look. I can bite, too.
I wish I could talk to you. I wish I didn't have so many stupid words. Just get in the way.
You're a million years old, and, you know, this would just complicate things. This is business. We're in business together. And, you know, I mean, things have just been totally insane. I need some clarity, so I'm just going to go take a shower, a really cold shower, and you just stay there.
Will continue in a moment here on ABC. Continues.
How long have you been in this country?
How'd you get in this country without a passport?
What kind of eccentric tribal rituals are you involved in that might harm the personage of a United States citizen?
None. I am a U.S. citizen. I've never even been to Hungary. I was in France once. I got food poisoning from the snails and I barked the entire time I was there.
Interesting story. But why are you dressed in this exotic fashion?
Low self-esteem, okay?
Sorry, you're gonna have to stay here until you've been processed.
When I get to make a phone call. I can't believe I was almost shipped off to Hungary. I don't even know anyone in Hungary. They don't make my facial masks in Hungary. My facialist is Romanian. They're going to come back for Lucy. We're going to have to be careful.
I will. I'll be very careful. Very, very careful.
Well, she's going to be making goulash.
You know what? I've got to get her to bed early tonight. She's got a big photo shoot in the morning.
David, how can you have her do a photo shoot tomorrow? You know, you're going to overload her. Look at her. The last thing she knew, she was chasing a mastodon, and it started raining. She's not going to be able to handle a big photo shoot.
Okay, voice of doom. She's going to have fun tomorrow, you know? She's going to have makeup on and lots of cool clothes on and people paying attention to her and bringing her bottled water and stuff. I know what I'm doing. I'm in control. If I say she's going to have fun, then you can believe me. She's going to have fun. Come on.
She's not going to have fun.
All right. Let's get our little nibbler under the lights and out front here, where we can put some makeup, hair, and wardrobe on our darling and actually try to sell this ghastly stuff. And as someone famous once said, can't we all just get along?
This is my star. This is my gorgeous, magnificent star.
Oh, yes, we're all so terribly much in love. Well, enough huggy-huggy, kissy-kissy. Come on, people, let's get back to work.
I don't know. It's not animal enough.
No, there's something wrong.
She's got lipstick on her teeth.
I
get it
see
off.
That. She keeps eating.
Right there.
Your teeth.
No, your hair is all up. Looks like your brain exploded.
She won't open her mouth.
it wild. Make it live. I want it to look alive out of her head. I want the hair to be wild.
The hair is all over the place, like you put it on with a flank steak.
Will you stop? Let me see her, because she keeps eating and sweating.
Hey,
come
your
here.
Hair band ain't right.
Let's
you got to fix
terrible.
Your hair band.
Marcus,
hey,
please.
I'm trying to help her out.
Marcus, I don't have the patience for this right now.
Okay, everyone back off. I'm feeling the news. Okay, Lucy, darling. Let's see the primal in you.
Show me the animal.
Okay, pose.
Don't just stand there.
Let's go.
Lucy, you've got to do something. This is a professional shoot. Don't just stand there. Do something.
Move. Give me something I can wear. Come on.
Lucy.
Come on.
Give us something.
Go, girl.
With your eyes.
Go.
You're going back to Hungary faster than you will say goulash.
Listen, the little fool.
All right, I'll handle this.
Envision this. You, out of work, living in your car, licking grease off of used burger wrappers. It isn't pretty, is it, Devin?
Lucy, look at me.
Okay. What's wrong? What do you want? If you just do this, okay, I'll get you ice cream. On a cone. You never had a cone before.
Bite me.
Don't say bite me, okay? Look. Furball, okay? If you just do this photo shoot, you can eat furball, all right? Focus, Lucy, focus. Okay? You're embarrassing me. Doesn't it even matter to you that you're humiliating me?
Oh,
What did you do to her?
Why is it always me? I didn't do anything. How did I become this heinous subhuman creature guy? Look, she totally freaked out at the photo shoot, and now whatever meager career I almost had is totally destroyed. What are you eating?
It must be a sandwich. You want some?
Oh, my whole life is falling apart. You don't eat meat.
Lucy eats meat.
Yeah, but... And why don't you have any strange product on your face that defoliates the dead skin cells and gets rid of whatever wrinkles you don't have?
Lucy isn't addicted to products, and her skin is beautiful.
Well, she's been frozen on ice. Hey, is that your real hair color?
Yeah, see, I've been thinking about it. So Lucy's prehistoric, right? Well, what does that really mean? I mean, if you take it literally, prehistory, pre-politics, pre-atomic bomb, pre-magazines, pre-newspapers, pre-Madison Avenue. You know, we're so mired in our history, we've forgotten how to just be. There are rules for everything. Walking and talking and eating and dressing. And if you don't conform, then you're an outcast. You know, so we starve ourselves, we bend our bodies because of these rules based in our history. But she doesn't know any of that, you know? She's just who she is. So I've been thinking about it.
Well, a lot of thinking.
Yeah, you should try it sometime. Hey, David.
What?
I got these from the school library. They're beginning anthropology books. I think you should show them to Lucy. I think she needs to understand where she came from.
Right now, I need to get into bed and just dream that none of this ever happened. And Chris?
Mm-hmm?
You do look pretty without that gunk all over your face.
Thanks, David. Thank you, Lucy.
Oh, no. Leave me alone. I want to function. I just want bed for the rest of my life. Never leaving bed. What? What? Really?
Wow. We're a star. Proof sheets from the botched primal shoot weren't so botched after all. Jean-Michel decided to center his whole campaign around Lucy. She was going to introduce his perfume at his défilé de mode show. People started treating me like I was cool. Like I was important. I was finally being recognized, and it felt good. It felt right.
Fiona?
What?
Cancel all my appointments.
You don't have any appointments.
Well, cancel them anyway. Roger,
yeah.
Get on the phone, start booking Lucy right away.
Whatever.
Let's get her on every magazine cover in the city. This is awful. Get her on the cover of Interview, get her a piece in Vanity Fair, and get her on the cover.
Just do what's great.
Okay. Not. I'd like to have her taken out to all the clubs. Let's get her pictures taken with all the Baldwin boys. Excuse me. People, we've got work to do. I'd like to see some effort. Fiona.
What?
Fan me. Roger, where are you, baby? Come on, time is our enemy. Let's move, people. Green means go.
With.
Come on in. Have a nice time. Oh, what the heck. Just for comic relief.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God. It's the bridal girl. Cretans, wannabes, posers, everybody. It's Lucy. Take a look, Lucy. Go on, have a good time.
Not so fast. Who are you?
I'm David Horsenfeld. I'm with her.
Yeah, aren't we all?
No, really, I am.
Yes, come on, people. Let's move it. I haven't got all night. Yes, yes. All right. Yes. Hello. Love the outfits. Are you on the guest list tonight?
From the INS.
We're here to question one of your guests.
No.
Yes.
I'm sorry, you're not on the guest list. You don't get in, okay? I don't make the rules. I just enforce them. What are you going to do, arrest me? Okay, hit the road. Come on, move it. Bye. Hit the road, losers. Come on, make way for the losers. Let them through. Let the losers through. Come on, yes. Yes.
Very nice.
Why are you staring at Lucy, Dave? Can't have her. You're just gonna be a bummer to her now.
Look, I'm not gonna be
a bummer, okay? I'm her Svengali, baby. Don't you forget it.
Yo, Lucy's a dime. That's the 411. Yo, you tripping and bugging. Could Lucy be making bank and blowing up, coming off like she all that? Lucy is crazy bodacious, G.
Look, I'm not bugging, okay? She owes everything she is to me. You wouldn't believe how I found her.
Do you think anybody cares how you found her? Doubting it. It's not about you, Dave. It's all about her. She's Jean-Michel's accessory now. He's gonna be all over her, posing and preening. She's his girl, Dave. Very, very flavor of the nanosecond, but let me give you a few tips. Scream at them, call them losers, and belch a lot. You know, and if you pulled your front tooth out, you'd get a Lauren Hutton thing by way of deliverance. You're a real porker, right? So always eat in your wardrobe and kick over tables and drink a lot of water while plugging in electrical devices. Oh, and always, always spit at the photographer. They are such little masochists.
Come on, Lucy. Now, what's your secret? Now, spit it out. What kind of diet are you on, really? Info diet, liquids, carbs, what?
Candy!
If you don't get fat?
Revolution!
Revolution? What revolution? What's she talking about?
I don't know.
Conspiracy! More candy! Be free!
Be free! Magnifique!
What exactly is she to you?
She's my date.
frankly, I've had it. You see, we're standing here all alone at these strange parties holding your milk while you cavort and use words you don't understand and pretend we don't know what you are, even though we do know what you are.
And what, pray tell, is she?
You want to know what she is?
I'll tell you what she is,
okay? I'll tell you what she is, Mr. Hip Designer, pretentious, pseudo, shallow, untalented piranha, okay? She's a cave woman.
Well, of course she's a cave woman. She's an Andy Godiva. She's Cleopatra. She's a goddess who runs with the world. She, dare I say it.
I just want you to look at this and tell me if anything looks familiar.
Love myself.
Okay.
Lucy? Lucy?
May we search the premises?
You don't even have to ask, you know.
She's not here.
Well, my wife's crazy over her. Yeah, she keeps telling me she's free. Something about a revolution now. She can eat more candy. I never said she couldn't eat candy in the first place.
I like a woman I can grab up.
Mind if we search the back?
She's not here.
Going on here. Lucy, so you feel the whole diet industry is a conspiracy?
Conspiracy? Yes.
And that women are, what, being taken in because...
hungry. That is so true. I mean, women are hungry for self-love and acceptance. We need to release ourselves of these shackles, you know? I mean, these unforgiving social rules about our body size and the shame of our own hungers, we need to be free. Yes, be free.
You know,
can I just tell you, you are absolutely brilliant.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you know, it's a general philosophy that we should really think about in times like this that are perhaps tough. Lucy, you're very well spoken, young lady.
Sorry. And your ideas are complicated, yet simplistic.
Hey, I agree there. Very nice.
Let's stand for her, Michael.
All right.
Audience loves you. Today in Encino, a group of women have adopted the philosophy of Lucy, the new primal girl, and they are showing their support by smashing their scales. Lucy, the new primal model who doesn't believe in the fashion industry's bent on women's bodies, will be unveiling Jean-Michel's debut perfume Primal at his fall Défilé de Mode at the end of the week.
Hello, Immigration Naturalization Service. Mr. Jones or Mr. Smith? Mr. Jones! Here's a little tip for your Lucy. You know, the one you've been looking for. She'll be modeling this Friday at Jean-Michel's Défilé du Mode on Braxton Street. 7 o'clock. Yes, she'll definitely be there. See you in Hungary, Lucy.
Ow! Lucy, this is Yogi Paxel. He's going to be reading your energy grid. Okay?
You were sad.
Here.
Oh, very old. You lost your home and you lost your place. You can't go back. They can't have you back. You must live in this life and in this time. Heed my words. You must make peace with your new home.
New home. Much either, and he's a mess. I know. Why are
people in love so difficult? Hmm? Okay. Time to get a life. Add a few clues to your portfolio. There you are. Could you look worse? So, feeling sordid much?
Leave me alone. Ow! What'd you do that for?
Gee, I don't know, Alex. How about giving me Get Over It for 500?
Why are you being so mean to me? I'm a broken man.
You know what, David? I teach four-year-olds who have more insight into life than you have. You blew it. You had her, you used her, you didn't acknowledge your feelings for her, and at this point, I'm giving you credit even thinking you have feelings.
What do you mean, my feelings for her?
Hello? Could you be a guy more? You love her, David. You're in love with Lucy, and now you're going to have to get her back.
I can't get her back. She doesn't want me. She's got her new friends, new fame. New life, she doesn't want me.
How are you ever going to know? How are you ever going to know what your life will be like if you don't live it?
I tried to live it. It didn't work out.
Wrong. You live around it. You know, and that's the easy way to live your life. Above it, on the side of it, at an angle somewhere. But you never fall in it and get dirty. You know? And that's where the life is. On the inside. All the love and the pain and the joy and the sorrow, it's all inside.
What are you, my therapist?
No, I'm your friend. And I'm just saying that God or the universe or something a lot stronger than us is giving you a chance to have a really happy life. But it's your choice. But I hope you do right by yourself. And by Lucy.
Chris was right. It was up to me. It was up to me to stop feeling sorry for myself and get Lucy back. I wondered if she'd take me back. But if I was going to get her back, it would have to be on her turf, where everybody could see it. The fashion show. The debut of Jean Michel's Primal. The perfume wouldn't be the only thing debuting. I had my own plan.
I'm famous, very famous. I go to all the openings, do all the commercials. What do I need an invitation for? No, you make it difficult for me. Boy, you're going to have your day.
Really?
Why do I have to wait out here? It's hot and I'm special. I'm very, very special. You know, I shouldn't have to be here. I've been modeling since I was 13. I've been all over the world, even Egypt. I hated it. Couldn't get a decent biscotti anywhere.
Yeah, I have friends here.
I'm working on this thing, but I'm beginning to hate my job.
What do you do?
I suck up. What do you do?
I teach kids.
Oh, that's great.
No, it's so great. You know, kids are so smart. They see things they don't like and they call it. You know, we lose that somewhere along the way.
Yeah, I know. Look, I don't want to sound like an idiot, but do you want to get a cup of coffee afterwards?
We have someone deported for blowing bubbles.
I'm not sure that's in the manual.
Well, it ought to be.
Thank you.
jobs.
Those are my combs and brushes! Those are my combs and brushes!
Listen to me, you hanger. Nobody likes you. You're here to help sell clothing.
That's it! End of novella!
You want it? You got it. Get testy with me. I'll put a wig on you. You hear that?
How's it going? You can hear it down the hall.
She can fall off the catwalk and break a neck for all I care.
Get out of the way! Get out of my way!
Ooh, you've upped that Stefan.
I want the music blaring. I want lots of things, all right? Go.
Go!
Animate. What? Where is my cave woman? Where is she?
What is this?
I don't understand. Marvin, I want some explanation.
Jean-Michel, you said you wanted an animal. I've delivered you an animal. She's getting in character.
But she's foaming at the mouth.
And it's authentic.
Wardrobe, door up. Be careful. She's in character, whatever that means. All right. People! Let's start the show.
Shoulder.
I think it's time for school.
procurement of fashionable items used to boost one's own sense of satisfaction.
She
and
went from saying two words to learning 2 million. She takes my breath away. She's cool, she's smart, and I adore her, especially when she orders me around.
Yes.
So that's the way I fell in love with a cavewoman. I highly suggest you try it sometime.